The title of the research is Critical Analysis of Ethics and Governance in the Public Sector by Looking at United Nations and African Union Perspectives. United Nations and African Union Perspectives has been in existence for quite a number of years with the mandate of improving ethics and governance in the public sector. The main reasons for doing this research was to look how United Nations and African Unions influence the system of ethics to these member states by looking at 4 countries, South Africa, Tanzania, Mauritius, and Botswana. The main research questions on this was how United Nations and the African Union deal with the ethics and the governance according to their perspectives. And second one, how United Nations and the African Union influence their ethics and the governance, how effective are and the challenges encountered in dealing with ethics and the governance to the member states. The significance of the start was knowing the system of ethics and the governance and practiced by United Nations, the African Union, will help to adjust and unfold the maladministration to these public sectors. The research methodology was quite on qualitative means, and it was analyzed by thematic analysis. It was collected through interview protocols. The findings from the research seems that United Nations and the African Union are partly effective and moderately effective on dealing with ethics and the governance. And it was concluded that in order for United Nations and African Union to deal with ethics and the governance, they have to impose some sanctions and penalties to these member states. Otherwise, ethics and the governance will still persist in an ethical way because they are less effective in dealing with the ethics and the governance to the member states, focusing Tanzania, Mauritius, Botswana, and South Africa. Thank you.
Question for Emmanuel.
I want to dominate, so guys, you need to ask questions. So I'm just filling the space while you're thinking. So please think for the next question. This will be my last question before Tito. So what I'd like to ask you is, ethics can be used as a noun, or you can talk about ethical governance. Right. So I would like you to, if you could just tell us a little bit more, did you look at specific ethics? Or did you look at how those ethics were used in the application of governance?
There are 2 strands of ethics. There is deontological perspectives and theological perspectives. But in relation to this research, I was looking how ethics and the governance are used to influence the development of public sector of these member states by looking how United Nations and African Union perspectives, how these bodies at the so-called big organization influence their ethics and the governance to these member states under their umbrella.
Question there.
Yes. Why those 4 countries? I expected maybe it would be more interesting if we looked at the hotspots where we have problems.
Now, I took 4 countries for various reasons. One, Botswana is said to be the leading government or the leading government in Africa in ethics and the governance. So it looks like a role model. South Africa is the last country in Southern Africa and Southern countries to gain independence. So expecting that they can imitate something good from where they emitted from apartheid system and so forth. Tanzania has been stable for a long time because it's the calm situation, it's the calm government, no conflict compared to other countries. But Mauritius and Botswana, they look alike on the issues of governance and ethics. So these 4 countries have got a lot of pull to give a lesson to these other countries that what are we imitating from them and why can we learn from there? That is 4 countries.